Hey, so, let's play. Yeah, might as well try to, oh, wait, never mind. It's still updating. Fuck me. Okay, let's do raft. Why the fuck not? And beautiful's good. Fantastic. It'll probably should slow down my computer too much. Oh god. Okay, let's delete this one because I barely. Actually, nah, I'm gonna play it. I barely started in this one. The Die Sharks one was like really far. Oh my god. Okay. Do I have enough stuff to make? No. Oh, but I should make rope though. Not much rope. Okay, yeah, I need more scrap. That sucks. Oh, scrap. Shit. Why is my computer slowing down so much right now? Oh, yeah, I have a ton of shit open. Oh, God, my. Come on, come. Come to. There we go. Why do you. Okay, I'm gonna go back and change the settings. I should. I'm not even using this, so I should close it. Yeah. Cancel. I just want to close it. There we go. And. Recordings, not downloads. Not recordings. That, I'm going to need that after this. Okay, close that. And that's good. I'll bookmark it. No. Okay, is it still recording? Yeah, okay, yeah. Just in case. Oh, it's pretty much almost done, so. I'm gonna do what the game I originally planned. Okay. Let's double check what's in this update. This is it. Okay, you can't see me, but it's like it's so perfect. For those of you who don't know, or if you don't really follow the game too closely, or just the development of the game, Yandere Dev, the guy who's pretty much the main dude in charge of this whole game, he made. Well, he didn't make it. He got someone to make some art panels for a visual novel style game for, I think it was the anniversary of this game. I'm trying to remember. I've been following him for a, following the game, I mean, for like a year now. And it's hard to keep everything straight. But basically, you in the visual novel, it was very short. You just played as this girl here, Midori Gurinu, and you end up going to the demon realm from the main game, and you meet the flame demon and learn his whole, like, backstory. Which, actually, now that I think about it, it might be cool if you were in Yandere Simulator. You could somehow, like, he could somehow incorporate how you find out about his past. Or maybe just a couple nods to this little thing. It was pretty, it was actually fairly interesting. What would this ship name be is all I can think of. Like, Green Fire? No, that's stupid. No. Just no. Oh, God, I should not. It's 1:15. 1:16, actually. Now. Extracting. Okay. On to the bug fixes. I got so off track there. Changes, fixes, and additions. Fix bug that was causing the camera to be. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that sensor shell thing was annoying. Okay. I never encountered this particular bug, but it sounds entertaining. If I'm being honest. Change the school logo. Fix bug. Oh, that have a taste thing. Yeah, that did get annoying because I kept running into that one. I'm seriously curious about this 3D model. Like, which was it? Like, I'm not good at finding that hidden stuff. Other people are, though. Oh. Oh, and he updated this. Wait for a week. I can see that. Personally, I was in the yes immediately. So, I guess I was in the minority on that one. Let's see, is this done yet? Yes, okay. So, what do I, oh yeah. You don't, nothing to see here, folks. Okay, let's play High School Murderer Simulator. Let's be honest here. Oh my God, load faster. Why? I wish I knew how to, like, close Skype completely without having to log back in every single time. Fast. Good. That's about what I can play it on this laptop. Considering everything I have on it, I mean.
Yandere Simulator is supported by the following sponsors.
Okay, so it's the volume's all the way up. I'm not quite sure how to control it to make sure you guys hear it, so. Like, I really want to make sure you guys can hear it, basically, is what I'm saying. Speaking of being able to hear, I really hope you can hear my voice. I'm, like, you saw it's like 1 in the morning and I'm recording this just for the hell of it because I want to try getting into Let's Playing and stuff. I think they're cool, but this is, probably isn't the only type of video I'll be doing. I don't know, I'm really interested in YouTube in general. Anyway, might as well go to new game. I don't do the senpai thing very often, but for this first video, why not? Guess why not? Okay. 10. Got that nice, like, well, that's not even, no. That's the closest to what I'm looking for. Probably. Sorry if this isn't all that entertaining. I'm mostly doing this for myself because I want to do it, and I don't know. I just got recently. I'm still working on getting out of a pretty bad patch in my life right now, and I'm mostly like I don't want to have regrets is the thing, is where I'm kind of leaning towards lately. And I just, when there's something I want to do, I want to get it, I want to do it right, like, as soon as possible. Because, honestly, I just... I don't know how to explain this. Yeah, let's go with that, and then no face shield here. Basically, I'm trying to find things I like again. Like, I'm basically trying to figure myself out completely, just from scratch. This is my favorite pairing of uniforms, by the way. You know what? Just enough about me.
I can't feel anything.
I haven't watched this
for as long as I can remember. I've never been able to feel emotions. I pretend to be normal when I'm around other people, but on the inside, I feel nothing. It's not as bad as it may sound. I know that I'm broken, but I don't care. This is normal for me. But everything changed when I met him, my senpai. For the first time, I felt something. A strong desire, a longing, a yearning, a craving. Now I finally understand what it means to be human, to be alive. I'm addicted to the way he makes me feel. I don't care about anything else. He is everything to me. And now, someone is trying to take him from me. She wants him, but not in the same way that I want him. She could never appreciate him the way I do. She doesn't deserve him. He belongs to me alone. She has taught me a new emotion. Rage. I want to stop her. I want to hurt her. I want to kill her. There is nothing I won't do for Senpai. I won't let anyone come between us. I don't care what I have to do. I don't care who I have to hurt. I don't care whose blood I have to spill. I won't let anyone take him from me. Nothing else matters. No one else matters. Senpai will be mine. He doesn't have a choice.
Oh god, it always glitches like that at first. Okay, before I move on, I just want to say I really like the way that intro seems to be coming along. I think it's so perfect and it sets this tone for this game so well. But I doubt that the dev will actually see this video, considering how popular Yandere Simulator is getting, but if he somehow does manage to find this at some point, I just want to say, I love your work so far on the game, and once this game is fully finished, I honestly can't wait to see what else you move on to do. Like, I just think this is going, like, being so well done. And you know, just all the love. Just, yeah. Okay, let's get past this awkwardness and just let's listen to this.
Do I know you? I saw you stalking an upperclassman today.
Do you have a problem with that?
No. I wanted to give you some information about the girl he was with. Her name is Osana Najimi. She has a crush on him.
She's also not fully implemented yet. People have gotten around, like, the dev has put up blocks to prevent people from adding Osana to the game in her current state because she is unfinished and he has said as much. And personally, like, I want to respect the dev's wishes. And, I mean, I've watched a few Let's Plays where people got to it, like, got past the blocks, I mean, and added her. But I really only watched them because I need to get my Yandere Simulator fix. Like, I watched at least one Let's Play of it a day lately, and like, I just like the game that much is basically what that means. but I don't plan on watching any more videos where people, like, got past the blocks because I really want the first rival to be as much of a surprise as possible. Anyway, on with this.
She believes in the myth about the cherry tree behind the school.
The myth that if you confess your love to someone underneath that tree on a Friday, they are guaranteed to accept your confession?
Correct. She's planning to confess to him next Friday.
Why are you telling me this?
I would be happy if something bad happened to Osana-chan. I think you might be the right person to give her what she deserves.
Who are you?
I'm the person nicknamed Info-chan at school.
I've heard rumors about you. You blackmail girls and sell panty shots to boys. Nobody knows your real name.
The rumors are true. If you ever need a favor, text me a panty shot and I'll give you whatever support I can. If you want to know personal information about anyone at our school, just send me a photograph of their face and I'll tell you everything I know about them.
You're disgusting.
You're a stalker. If you want my help, text me. If you don't care, ignore me. You have 1 week until your precious senpai belongs to Osana-chan. I hope you make her suffer.
Oh, that's cool. I didn't notice. When did he change the date to 2018? Like, I remember when he changed it to 2017, but I don't remember exactly what build he changed it to 2018. Like, I didn't notice that till now. Anyway. Yeah, let's get on with the actual gameplay. Go with stealth. Like, it is so useful once you get into the actual game. Okay, let's get going, guys. Oh wait, first settings, outlines off. Personally, I think it looks a lot cooler with the outlines off. And low detail, I'll turn them 100 meters. Let's do 80. 80 meters draw distance. I generally like to keep it to 180. Went too far. The fog, I think, is a really cool idea. Shadows, yeah. It's an animation. Yeah, we'll leave them on. Low detail. Actually, let's put that down to, yeah, 70. 70 sounds good. And then,
let's go here.
And instead of getting panty shots the normal way, which is a pain in the ass, I'm gonna use the debug menu cheat, which is the slash right under the slash button right under the backspace button, and then you hit P to get if, as you can see here, it gives you 20 panty shots each time you do it, so I usually do it a bunch of times, like, and let's see how much I got. See, I get, I'm up to 120 panty shots just from doing that. Now, actually, before I continue, one thing I want to say is, the debug menu will not be in the actual game. It's just, well, as the name implies, it's just for the debug builds. But they're useful shortcuts while the game is still in development, especially if you've played this before. Especially with as many times as I personally have played it before, actually. Pick rows, just just because I can, really. Shoes. Black, white, black, white, black, white, black, white. I prefer the white, personally, because, well, I like the contrast, really, is the main thing. Okay, let's see here. Let's bring that down to, 30 is too close. 40. I think 40 is probably better. Actually, again, draw distance, let's bring it down to, wrong direction. Let's bring it down to 100, just for the hell of it, I guess. Also, because I'm trying to fix the frame rate on this. Why is my frame rate so sucky right now? Like, that was the usual settings I use, and it usually runs so smoothly. It's weird. Like, even with all the stuff I have open, it usually runs faster than this. Because I always have a ton of shit open all the time. Like, this girl. Okay, this girl right here. Not you. This girl. I fucking love her hair. Those skull things. Just. Yes. Yes. A million times. Just. Yes. I love it. Oh, let's go check out our senpai. The purple-haired asshole. Which, I have nothing against purple hair. In fact, I'm thinking about getting purple hair myself. It's more like, I don't get what Ayano here, you know, our Yandere. I don't get why she chose to fall for this dude. Out of all the interesting people, just this boring ass. This boring asshole. Although, he seems to have that effect on women, considering the final game is going to have 10 rivals, all completely different from each other. So, like, I don't know. Actually, speaking of rivals, I won't show you Osana. Mostly because I don't know how to get past those blocks. But I can show you here, the nurse here. Oh, and this steel key option was added in a recent build. I forget the exact date. And she was recently made to be able to move. Because before, she just, like, stood here, like this, basically. She stood pretty much exactly right. Actually, it was more around here. And, like, she just stood there. You couldn't do anything. But, she's actually gonna end up being one of the rivals, eventually. Like, one of the ones towards the end, I think, if I remember correctly. Oh god, what should I do? I've played this game to death so many times on my own. I don't know what to show you guys. Okay. Bring up seduction by hitting S. And reputation by hitting R. And then hit 7 to go up to the classroom. And then, again, debug commands. Hallelujah. Hit the slash button under the backspace button to do that, and then hit P to do that, and then just I have these five points, so I'll put them in all of them, and there we go. See, you need biology rank 1 to use tranquilizers, which I might or might not do. I'm not sure, honestly. Chemistry, I don't think it does. Oh, I see what it does, the poison thing. Okay, chemistry is poison. Language, this is what allows you to write the suicide note. That's right. You can write notes and put them in lockers at any time, but the suicide notes, you have to have language rank 1. Physical rank, these are so good to have, but especially the rank 1, which allows you to carry corpses instead of dragging them, because if you drag them, oh my god, it takes like 2 hours. But the game's not supposed to be easy. Obviously, but just carrying them is, you even get a little faster when you're carrying them, I think, which is, I don't know, I'm not sure if that's intentional or what, but I just think it's a useful thing. Run faster, run faster, run faster, run faster. And psychology doesn't do anything yet. Oh, and since I hit the P, it put the eye patch. Sorry. Yeah, the P button messes with the accessories you have on the eye, so you can put the eye patch, and there are the eye patches and a pair of glasses like you just saw, and then the O button changes other accessories. See, that was a piece of toast, this is a toaster, like I think this is a bubble, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's bubble tea, and that's a popsicle, little senpai doll. I'm really tempted to say voodoo doll because that's what it looks like. Oh yeah, this whole, like, devil horns and wings and tail set. Oh, yeah. Panties on the face. That's a good reference, the panties. And this little octopus guy. He used to have a little hat, but now it's on, like, a llama thing in the light music club. It's hard to explain this. I'm already rambling on too much as it is, really. Oh, and I love this, like, hat with the monocle and the mustache and the little pipe. And when you go to laugh, instead of laughing, it makes funny little, like, British-sounding quips, which I think is just hilarious.
Awesome. You have insulted a lady. I ought to take off my belt and thrash you within an inch of your life, sir.
Yeah, that one's my favorite quote.
Fiddlesticks. Oh, bother. Tea and crumpets. What? Pip-pip? There's a good fellow. Balderdash. Jolly good. Fiddlesticks.
And I think I've gone through them all. This steak thing, I don't get why it's here. I'm not sure if it's a reference to something. If it's a reference, then you know what the reference is, please tell me. But yeah, I don't know why that's there. Oh, and this, I'm pretty sure, is a Despicable Me 2 reference. It's like the tortilla chip hat with the guacamole and the brim. And this is the, I can't remember her name, but she was one of the antagonists of Gravity Falls. Yeah, I can't. Giffany, that was it. Giffany, that was the antagonist's name, not protagonist. And then there's this, like, piano, rainbow piano thing. I just think this thing is cool. And this is the Supersonico signature headphones. Oh, that's right, the Mario. Oh, I could have sworn she said something, but maybe not. Are these the ones that meow? Yeah. Yes, it is. Just a bunch of different meows. This is just a bow. That could be a reference to so many things. These are just cat ears. They don't make the noise. Yeah, no, they don't. And then this thing, which I am thoroughly convinced this is a reference to Homestuck, Damara from Homestuck, because she had this little thing in her hair, I could have sworn, but maybe not, I don't know. And then, this little, like, bunny hair clip. And then, I don't know, red clown nose ball thing. And then the flower over her eye, which I want to say is a Kill la Kill reference? I don't know. I'm not sure if this hat is a reference. These are like wolf ears, I think. Oh, here's a little llama. Oh, I need to go to class before I fuck up. If I've just put in anything. Anyway, back to what we were doing. The little llama with the top hat. I just think... That's right, this is what... The top hat also went to this llama. But the top hat actually... This used to be just like the plain llama. And the squid had the top hat. Actually, it might be an alpaca. Now I think about it, because there's a game, I can't remember what it's called, but it's like, you're like a mutant alpaca, and you have to absorb other normal alpacas into you? Oh yeah, there's this little mask thing, but I can't remember how, like, you can change the facial, the expressions on the mask by hitting one of the buttons, and I can never remember the button for it. Oh yeah, this hat, this is a reference to, I'm pretty sure it's a reference to Dragon's Crown. It's a little known JRPG kind of game. It's like, I only know that because I have it for the PS Vita, whatever you want to call it. And the witch class has like this hat, and it looks, but I could be wrong, it could be a reference to a different witch hat, I don't know. Oh, what's this? Oh, this must be one of the new ones he put in. This is nothing. Okay, so back to normal Yanchan. And then, let's see, hairs. Oh boy, there are so many different hairstyles now. I wish it were easier to cycle through the hairstyles, because it's really hard to get to the ones I want with the way it's set up currently. Here. This is a pretty good angle spot, I think. Okay, this was, yeah, that. Oh, yeah, that. And then this. And then twin tails. Twin drills. Normal long, and then really long. Which I actually, this is one of my favorites. The only problem is it's too floppy. And like, when you run, it goes crazy. Here, watch. Like, look at this. Yeah, that's my only problem with this hairstyle. This is a reference to an anime that I have not seen yet. I just know, I know it's a reference to an anime character, I just don't know the character. And this is, pretty much the Yandere Queen herself. The hairstyle. Yuno Gasai from Mirai Nikki. Or, if you watch the dub, then it's Future Diary, but I personally prefer the sub so far in that series. Legend of Korra. The hairstyle, I think this is Super Saiyan. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Super Saiyan. Not really sure what this is a reference to hairstyle. Oh, and this was Rival-chan. This was supposed to see Rival-chan right here. See, she was the original look for Osana, but she wasn't tsundere enough in the way she looked. Personally, I was watching one of the videos from one of the people I follow for Yandere Simulator content, and they said something about having her, this girl, still be in the game, but as Osana's younger sister or something, and I kind of like that idea, but I was thinking maybe something more along the lines of, because I want her to stay in the game too. She's been a staple for so long in the game. I kind of think it'd be cool, Yandere Dev mentioned in a past video that he wants to make consequences for having different levels of reputation. If you have really low reputation, then pretty much everyone hates you, no one will talk to you. But the upside of it would be that... Oh god, voice cracked. But the upside to it would be that you could join the delinquents. But, on the opposite side of the spectrum, you have if you had high reputation, then maybe you'd be super popular and there would be people following you around and stuff, making it hard to get away with things. Certain yandere things, if you catch my drift. Anyway, back to hair. Oh, Pippi Osu's hair, I'll show you her later, maybe in a different video. Info-chan's hair, is this a reference, is it not, I don't know. Different variations of that same pink hairstyle. I like this white hairstyle for whatever reason. I don't really know why. This I kind of like, but again, the physics, man, it goes nuts when you run. It's not too bad when you're walking, but when you go to run, it's just ugh. There's this little bun thing. I don't know what that's called. Oh, and this is the bun of the counselor, which actually, I can show you the counselor. Although I won't explain her. I'll probably do it in some other video or something. But this is the counselor, and see, it's basically, it's her hairstyle. Pretty much. Oh no, it's changed slightly. This used to be her hairstyle. Huh. When did that happen? I didn't even notice. It did though. This used to be her hairstyle. Let's see here. Next hair. I think it might be a Kill la Kill reference. Let's see. I just really like this one. I think it's so pretty. And then this, I really want to say this is a Ruby reference. Sorry, I can't speak for shit right now, for whatever reason. This, I think this is a pretty cool, like, short hairstyle. This, I know for a fact, is Kill la Kill reference. It's, Yugo Matoy. That's right, it's the main character's hairstyle. This is a Higurashi, reference to one of the characters. I've never watched the anime myself, but I had a friend who was really into Higurashi, and, like, they would not rest until I at least saw a picture of the cast, so that's all I really know. I also know she's a yandere, but pretty much everyone in that show is a yandere at some point, so I don't know. I think this is cool. I kind of get that Melanie Martinez vibe from this one. That's mainly why I like it, because I'm huge. Fuck me. Okay. Sorry. Need to plug this in. And there we go. Okay. Loading. There we go. Okay. We're back. But yeah, Melanie Martinez is what I get from this. Again, another reference to an anime I haven't seen yet. Evangelion? Is that how you say it? I don't know. I haven't seen it yet, like I said. I just think this one looks cool mostly because of the flower. I really like the flower. The rest of it is just kind of meh to me. This is nice. This is another variant of it. Oh yeah, I really like this one. I kind of get a really nice, like, island girl kind of vibe from this hairstyle. And me, personally, I grew up on Maui, and it reminds me of home and my family back there and stuff. I don't know, it just makes me happy. And then, oh yeah, this one. Was this one of the newer ones? I think it was. Actually, maybe not. I'm not quite sure. But it's nice all the same. I just wish this one had some physics to it, because I always think it's weird when it goes into the back like that. Anyway, this one, if it's a reference, again, I don't know it. This one's pretty cool, and it, like, gives you all, like, these, like, piercings in your lip and stuff. I personally wouldn't do that, just because, like, I have no problem with other people who do it. I just personally, it's my personal preference that I wouldn't want to do it. I think this is another character reference, I don't know. Oh, yeah, I really like this one, but again, there's no real physics on it, it just kind of goes through. Oh, wait, no. But it does kind of need some physics, because curls like this would bounce, because I've actually had curls like this in the past. Miku Hatsune, I think that's a pretty easy to get reference. Again, no physics, but again, like, most of these hairs don't have physics. I think this one's cool. I don't really know if it's a reference. This one's interesting. Like, it's very, like, avant-garde and kind of look, I don't know. Is this a reference? Is it not? This to me looks like Applejack from My Little Pony. I'm pretty sure this is an anime character, but I don't know who. Again, don't know who this hairstyle is. This is Mei Misaki from Another. Like, the anime is called Another. It's a horror Psychological thriller, horror, mystery, paranormal kind of. It's awesome. I just don't know how to, like, explain it any better than that. This might be a reference, I don't know. This one looks cool. This is one of the newer ones. Again, I think this one looks pretty nice. Again, one of the newer ones. This one's very interesting. I kind of almost wish this hairstyle were on that one of the Rainbow Six is with those, like, girls who usually stand right around here in a circle. Actually, they Oh, it's only for something in the game, so they should still be here in the cooking place. Yeah, here we go. See, this girl with the blue... Well, not... This is Saki. That's more aquamarine hair. This girl with the blue hair, I feel like this would look a lot better on her. But at the same time, I really like that bun. Like, she's really rocking that bun style. So, I don't know. That's just my personal thoughts. Anyway, this one. Oh, I get it now. I think this one is a reference to what's her name from Naruto. But when she was younger. God, I can never remember her name. I swear, I'm so horrible. This, it's okay, I mean, it's nothing. This one is like, whoa. It just looks cool to me. And then there's this one. This one's nice too, with the purple with the pink streaks. Oh, and it's got physics to it, which is nice. And then this one, I think this is a character reference. If it's a character, this one's, I don't know about this one. Like, I like it, I just don't know if it's a reference. This one I like just because I like long hair and, like, lots of hair. And I like, oh, it does have physics. I thought it didn't have physics. Oh, it has some physics, okay. It has slight physics. And this one, I really like this one, mostly because it's purple, and my favorite color actually is purple. Like I was saying before, like earlier in the video, oh god, I gave him pink hair instead of purple, didn't I? Fuck. Yeah, I'm not going back and doing that. I mean, fixing it. This is nice. I like it. This one's pretty cool too. I think this is actually another reference, actually, now that I look at it more. Like, oh god. I can't remember the anime, but it's so good. It was one I just finished recently. This one's pretty, because I also love this, like, kind of aquamarine and teal shades of blue. This one's really cool because I love the pairing of pink and green. Also, there was a book by the title of My Life in Pink and Green, and it was a really good book, at least at the time. I haven't read it recently. I read it more towards, like, middle school. And then this hairstyle, I think it looks nice. Why did this pop up? I really hate you. Why are these stupid ads popping up? I really hate it. Like, I've been having this problem lately, and I don't know why. Oh god. Okay, here we go. We're getting back into things. And here we go. Okay, this is better. Like, a lot better. Yeah, so that's another new hairstyle. Oh, I don't think I saw this one. I guess I went by it too fast. This is, I like it. It's kinda, I don't know why, I just like it. I'm pretty sure this is, Minecraft reference. And then bald, with a little, like, barcode on here, which, if I remember correctly, is a reference to the Hitman games, because Yandere Dev is a big fan of the Hitman games, as he stated in multiple videos. And before you say anything, yes, I do know way too much about this game. But I pretty much have no life, so that's not too surprising. Anyway, oh god, how long have I been recording? I don't even know. Okay, let's check this. And let's see. And of course it doesn't tell me. Oh god, I've been recording for like an hour. Oh my god. Well, I think I'm gonna end this here, actually. Yeah, so I've been talking way too much. If you watch this to the end, thank you very much. I might continue with this, I might not. You never know. Especially with me. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. This is gonna be my first video on my new, like, more full-on YouTube channel, as opposed to, like, a more personal channel with my real name and stuff. Thanks for watching, and I hope you all have a good, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, just know that you are loved. And I want this to be a, like, judgment-free channel as much as possible, which is gonna be kinda hard considering, hey, I'm giving my opinions on the internet. But yeah, just thank you, and hopefully we all get to talk to you guys some more. That's it. Goodbye, good morning, good night. And if you're going to bed after this, sleep tight. Yeah. Goodbye.